Lloyd's mate hires out limos. He reckons he'll do us one for next to now.
It better not be dodgy.
No, no, it's all kosher. I promise. Just leaves the best man situation.
I told you it's sorted.
Kirk, he'll be heartbroken if he can't do it. Billy'll understand.
Billy or no Billy, Kirk's not up to it. You could chuck him in chimping clothes at Chester Zoo and he still would be best man. He's good-hearted, like, but he's a moron.
But he won't have much to do.
He'll be in charge at Ring for a start. I wouldn't trust him with a Ring donut.
You're not giving him a chance.
If he could somehow prove to me he could do it, I'd reconsider. But there's no ways.
Yeah, there is.
Who rattled your cage?
We're doing a project on Greek myths.
Only no one. There's me and Adonna.
Hercules had to prove he was safe killing his wife and kids. He did it by performing 12 great labours.
Fact that a consolation to his missus.
Don't you say you could do the same with Kirk?
Oh, yeah. He could do 12 tasks to show you were good enough to be your best man, Uncle Les.
Don't be so...
No, no. Hear him out. What were these tasks?
They were like killing legendary creatures and that. I can just see Kirk battling with big monsters.
Oh, aye. There's lots of them round here. Perhaps he could slay Janice.
You could update the task more, though. Like, make him fit in today. Like, cleaning the stables of Aegeus. You could just find him somewhere real filthy and make him clean it up.
Oh, I don't know, kids. It's a bit daft.
Hold on. I'm now, if not fair. Give us that list. I'll go through these. You go and find Hercules.
After God had finished the rattlesnake, the toad and the vampire, he had some awful substance left, with which he made a scab. A scab is a two-legged animal with a corkscrew sole, a water brain, and a backbone of jelly and glue.
It's for you, Mum.
Where did that come from?
It was on the doormat.
Oh, they've resorted to hate mail now.
Where others have a heart, she carries a tumour of rotten principles.
That's enough!
Do you know, that doesn't sound like the girls from the factory.
It's Jack London, the writer.
Did you print that off?
No.
Yeah, you did.
No, I didn't.
So how do you know who wrote it, then?
Craig's granddad told us.
Oh, so when did he get a chance to see it? If it's just landed on our doormat first thing this morning?
If there's anything worse than a scab, it's a snitch.
You really think your mum should risk your job for the likes of Janice Battersby?
Do you know, he's right about a watery brain, though. I mean, I used to think the others were thick until I worked with these load of imbeciles. It's a nightmare. I carry them all day. I work my socks off keeping those machines going, and I don't get a thank you from them, I don't get a thank you from any of the Baldwins, and I get loads of verbal abuse.
Well, join the pickets. Do something right for a change.
Well, I suppose I could always take a few days off, couldn't I, till it all blows over, go into town, do a bit of shopping. At least then I'd make the Baldwins realise just how much they need me.